guys, it's Sarah. Yes, I understand this light was very bright, but it was too hot to play with it anymore. Anyways, as you all know, I just got back from a voyage. J'ai voyagé au Canada. I'm actually pretty surprised that the amount of time I was in a French-speaking country, I did not pick up more French. Like, thank God most of Canada is bilingual and they can accommodate for people who speak English. Like, sometimes I just cringe at myself. I should be bilingual. Like, it's not fair to other people who come over to the US. Anyway, this is not the point of this video. You guys came here to hear some news and not hear me rant about my bad French. But anyway, enough of that. So here's the latest news that's been happening in the past couple weeks. So I know we do not care about this topic anymore. I understand we should have pushed it under the rug. So whether you guys saw it coming or not, Liam and Cheryl broke up. So Liam sent out this tweet last week saying, "Cheryl and I are sad to announce that we are going our separate ways. It's been a tough decision for us to make. We still have so much love for each other as a family. Bear is our world, and we ask that you respect his privacy as we navigate our way through this together." Now, I know I already expressed my opinion about this on Twitter. I kind of made jokes about it. I kind of seemed like I was happy. Hey, I remember syrup sandwiches and crumb allowances, but that's a new. So yeah, my true opinion is that I kind of saw this coming, like I'm not surprised. But also, I don't want to come across as like I'm happy that this happened, because I'm never happy that people break up. Like, you shouldn't be joyful about a person's breakup. So I'm not trying to seem like an asshole here. All I'm saying is that I just wasn't surprised, and I heard some of you say that you weren't surprised either. And to be honest, not to be shady or anything, but I kind of forgot that Liam and Cheryl were even together. Like, they're so private about their relationship, and I really just don't keep up on them as much anyway. So I was like, oh, they broke up? Okay. The news really didn't seem like news to me. So yeah, sorry about that, Liam. Hopefully you can find love soon, but in the time being, just focus on your music. And also, no surprise that the Sun was right on top of that shit. Right when they broke up, the Sun had to post an article like that. So again, no shock. Now, moving on to Harry Styles' concert news. Okay, so Harry had a concert in St. Paul on July 1st, and this is a concert that was so iconic. So much happened between what Harry did on stage, the things he said, the interaction with the audience. I mean, so much happened. And a lot of this stuff revolved around a lot of gay shit. So the first thing I'm gonna mention is Harry's interaction with fans and him reading fan signs.
The sign says, "Because of you, I'm coming out tomorrow. I have two things that are wrong about your sign. One, it's because of you that you're coming out tomorrow. And two, you just came out."
Okay, so there's a couple things I just love about this clip. Not only is the video just gay as fuck, but I love how Harry asks the fan, "Can I read this?" Because it's a very personal sign. He doesn't want to expose a fan who's a part of the community, because you never know. And that sign was specifically for Harry to see. So I like how when there's a personal message on a sign, Harry asks first if he can read it aloud to the whole crowd. And this isn't the first time he's done that. There's been other signs that have been personal as well that has had to do with coming out or being gay, and Harry has asked the fan, "Can I read this out loud?" And that is just full respect right there to the individual. And now on to the kinky side of the concert. So the reason why I'm talking about this concert in general is because Harry did so much kinky stuff on stage. Not only things he said, but in his actions as well. And we all know that Harry's usually pretty sexual on stage anyway, but this one was like full-blown kinky. So in this first clip, Harry said "daddy." Basically, the context was, "Will you take his hand in marriage?" And Harry says, "Yes, daddy, I will." What?
"Yes, daddy, I will. Yes, daddy, I will."
All right, daddy.
"Yes, daddy, I will."
Like, okay, Harry's bringing fanfics to life here. And also, not only that, Harry was discussing his nipples with another guy in the audience. Like, Harry's telling the guy how he has 4 and the other guy has 3, and he was like, "That's nothing, you're an amateur, like it's some competition or something."
"How many do you have? You have 3. Tough luck. Oh! Tough luck. You're looking at a guy with 4. that metric stuff. I don't want to hear about three. It's all about four.
Yeah, you heard that right. Harry was talking about chains and stuff. Like, does he do this in his free time? Is he joking around or is this for real? Because in my mind, I feel like he's not joking. And for any of you who don't understand kinks or kinky people, I'm gonna out myself right now and actually say that I'm kinky. I know none of you wanted to know that. But anyway, I'm just gonna shut up for a few minutes and show you guys all the videos of Harry being kinky on stage with like handcuffs and stuff, and just him being very entertaining on stage.
I do have one question for you, and I find this a touch worrying. This is a family show!
Fuck you!
Oh, is it? You mean give you my handcuffs?
Actually happened. In my opinion, I want Harry to be like this every single concert. Like, it is quite evident that Harry is becoming more and more confident as shows go on, and literally there's like what, like 5 or 6 left or something, which also makes me really, really sad that there's only that many shows left. Like, I feel like his tour just started. Like, what the heck am I gonna talk about in my videos now? But anyway, tell me all your thoughts about that below. Now, next in the news, we're gonna talk about Louis Tomlinson, his music, his album, and all his social media activity. So basically, we found out that Louis recently registered his trademark, which is his smiley face. So this says, on June 22nd, 2018, Louis registered his smiley face with X's for eyes as a trademark. It has not yet been granted by the EU, but is currently in process. The trademark is listed with Louis Tomlinson as the owner, not 78 Productions or any other company. It's a personally owned mark. The trademark requested would cover music-related items, clothing, and printed items. And it says underneath here, this is one mark owned by Louis Tomlinson. Yo, bitch, our boy is growing up. And again, I know I said this in my last video, but I'm so glad to see that Louis is making improvements, he's maturing, he's working so hard on his music, and he just really wants to make it good for us. And again, he's gonna have new managers as well. I can't wait to see what new stuff that brings him, maybe more freedom. And not only is Louis really active on Twitter and updating us, he's also very active on his Instagram. So first we got this selfie of Louis, obviously showing his 28 tattoo. I don't know what it is with Louis and his 28 tattoo, but it's obviously an obsession. Probably because that is his anniversary date. Like, do you guys think he's showing this tattoo on purpose because he knows we analyze it and he knows that we notice his 28? Or do you think he just likes doing the peace sign? Because guys, Louis already admitted in an interview that he knows what we say online, he knows we overanalyze, and he loves it. So I'm sure that's why he does the 28 all the time. He loves to see our reactions. So I don't know if that's coincidence, you know? And also on Louis' Instagram, he posted this picture of him with a guitar. And we all know a while ago Louis was learning guitar, but I mean, by this point, Louis's probably a pro at it, just like his husband. Like, that's awesome that Harry knows guitar now, Louis's also learning guitar, so that's so cool that Louis is learning another instrument, and I'm sure on his album we're gonna hear him play guitar. Like, imagine Louis performing live and him playing guitar. Oh my god. So now we have Niall, Harry, and Louis who know how to play guitar. I'm not sure if Liam does. Maybe he does though. Also, speaking of the Tomlinson family, Lottie recently had this launch that she was promoting on her Instagram. So over this past week, Lottie went to that event, and also we found out that Gemma was there supporting her. You know, the in-laws always support each other. And it's kind of funny how two mortal enemies' families would come together to support each other in an event, but Louis's beautiful girlfriend, Eleanor, wasn't there supporting Lottie, who is her boyfriend's sister. Eleanor is nowhere to be seen at Lottie's launch. If Danielle was able to show up at her lipstick launch, Eleanor should be able to show up as well. interesting how her brother's arch-nemesis stylist and makeup artist are there, but her brother's girlfriend is nowhere to be seen. Now look, I get it if Eleanor had another commitment and she couldn't go to Lottie's launch, that could have been the reason why she wasn't there, but in my opinion, I'm just tired of making up excuses for Eleanor's absence in their life, so I'm just gonna say that, Eleanor is probably not with Louis. I don't know what's going on with that whole thing. We haven't seen Eleanor in a while. But you know what? I already said this a few videos ago on my channel. I don't want to talk about Eleanor anymore. Like, she's really irrelevant to me, and I just don't like talking about her. Lottie doesn't need Eleanor there. She's pretty successful. Also, speaking of supporting, we got this post saying that Harry has donated a pair of his Gucci rainbow loafers to raise funds for the LGBT community, mental health, and the charity London Friend. And these are the loafers that got donated by Harry. Yo, those shoes are honestly iconic. Like, I don't need anyone to donate to me. I'm fine. But I do want those shoes. They're probably hella expensive though. So that just makes me so happy that Harry is donating to good causes, especially LGBT ones. And also speaking of LGBT stuff, Modest Management posted this. They posted their logo in a rainbow format, and it says, "Happy Pride from all at Modest." Now, please tell me this is a fake Modest account, because I wouldn't know. I don't follow Modest. I've just been seeing this go around on Instagram, and people have been sending it to me. I don't want to complain. Maybe Modest Management has, like, improved, changed their roots. I don't really know what their agenda is. I've seen a lot of people get angry at Modest for posting this, but in my opinion, if they're like at least trying to do something good, you know, for the LGBT community, saying happy pride, just let them, okay? Because it's a happy thing. I know we hate Modest, but maybe this is a good step in the right direction. Again, I don't really care about Modest either, and I'm sure One Direction don't even care what they do, you know? So yeah, tell me all your thoughts about all of this below. Anyway, guys, that is all the news for today. If I missed anything, just leave it down below. And like always, I make a new video whenever I want, so like and subscribe. All my social media is down in the description, and I will see you guys later. Bye.